Valentine's Day, 2020. A day my next guest, Emily, will never forget. You see, not only did she discover she was pregnant with her now one-year-old daughter, Gianna, Emily found out that the man she had been dating for the past 8 months, Charlie, was actually married to another woman. Since then, Charlie has denied baby Gianna and refuses to support Emily in any way. So, Emily, why are you so disappointed in him?
Because, like, he knew Gianna his, first of all. You could have told me you was married from the beginning.
You didn't know he was married.
I didn't. He told me we met at the convenience store. We grown, you know, to like each other and be in a relationship. And it's like, when we got deep, you know, in love or whatever, it was like, you know I've been through a divorce. I know what it's like, you know, us just expressing our feelings or what we've been through or whatever. Not now time that he said, oh, I'm still married.
Charlie thinks it was never serious between you two. That you knew that he wasn't.
She know that more.
That he wasn't.
He was at my house every night at 8:30. His kids at my house. We're doing Christmas and all of that together. What you mean we weren't together? What was it? Because I'm never fleeing. Please explain.
She know better than that. Before we even got in a relationship, she already knew that I was married. I was really going into a divorce.
No, she knew this.
And she was still dealing with it.
No,
acting like it was cool.
Let me let you know this.
She was going back and forth.
He just
tapped
me for TV. Let me tell you something.
Man, she knew what was going on, man.
I got facts.
No, ma'am.
You was in love. I ain't got no reason to be lying. Like I said.
You tripping. I wasn't in love. You tripping.
Like I said, you was in love. You called me crying in the McDonald's parking lot. Talking about, oh, you moved on too fast and this and that. Now.
Emily, why did you think you were so tight with him when you also said that he was a womanizer and he had all kinds of women?
I had to learn him, first and foremost. I had to learn him. And when I learned him, that's when I started making him uncomfortable. Because I started going to his phone, I started finding out who he really is. You ain't gonna know who a person is until you go on that phone. And him, baby, he got so many kids in Little Rock that he needed to come back on your show.
Well, what do you mean? In Little Rock, Arkansas, he has
all these
kids. I had six people reach out to me.
How many kids you got? You worried about my kids? All my kids situated, and you know that. That's why you trying to get situated. All my kids situated and happy.
Well, I ain't on here for 5,000, baby. GG Good. GG Good. She's situated.
That's why you trying to get in.
To let you know.
That's why you trying to get in. You know what's going on, fool.
Gianna's godmother and your friend, Chante, she's the one who's been taking care of the baby, right?
She's like, yeah, when I need a babysitter, when I run out of something and can't get her, or if I'm doing something, she there. My sisters, they right. There. I got a big support system. That's why I say I'm not here financially. I'm here because I want him to know that's his
I
baby.
I got it. Didn't you reach out to Charlie's father, Carlos? Didn't you reach out to him?
No, his dad reached out to me. They came to my house. Him and his side chick, because he got another wife, came to my house with a stroller, which my baby never got in, period. For him to be on here trying to act his grandchild.
I mentioned these two people because they're going to be on the show, and they're going to tell us their sides of the story. But now I want to talk to Charlie, because Charlie's also in Little Rock. So.
What's the deal, Mort?
20 kids.
Man, she tripping. If I had 20 kids, I had a soccer team. You hear me?
Right.
If I had 20 kids more, team. I have a soccer team. You hear me? Man, first off, before we even met, she was at one of my family members' repass. You feel what I'm saying? She was trying to get with me then. I blew off. You feel what I'm saying? Let me talk. Look, so
Emily.
We at the repass. So after the repass, I see you at the store. I so happened to just bump into her. You feel what I'm saying? We was having little dealings here and there. I just moved back from Texas. You feel what I'm saying? She knew that. So we was dealing here and there. You feel what I'm saying? It wasn't on no relationship type thing. You feel what I'm saying? And she
we was
knew
in
that.
A relationship.
I had different females that I was dealing with. You feel what I'm saying?
Did she know that you were seeing other females?
Yes. You just hear she said she was going through my phone. How would she know if I was dealing with other
That's
females?
That's what we were about.
You feel what I'm saying? How would she know
before
that?
I
you
even
feel
touched
what I'm saying?
Phone.
But look, check this out, Maury. This is my thing, though. Like, even when she was talking about she was pregnant,
Why aren't you in this? Why aren't you in this little girl's life?
Because I believe she's not mine. Like, soon she, look, more the week, the week after that she had her baby, she was in the bed with another dude. How would I know if that's my baby or not? I got pictures and et cetera to prove it.
Okay,
the same dude that she said she married or
You went on Facebook and you posted this.
I tagged you.
Right. If there's anybody with any children claiming to be mine, DM me and let's take it to the Maury Show. How many responses?
Straight up.
How many responses did you get?
Man, I had like 200 comments.
Oh, wow.
I had hundreds of comments, Maury. Hundreds
you
of
did
comments.
Not.
So, Shante, you're disappointed in Charlie. Why are you disappointed in him?
You know, this baby is innocent through it all. You get what I'm saying? Did you ever
see them together?
Yes, I actually stayed in the same apartment complex. I seen him there.
I don't need to know her. I ain't never seen her before. She probably just did her hair or something, Maury.
He do know that you have seen me. When you was walking out to take your daughter to school, you know you done seen me over there. But it's more so about
which one of my daughters?
I done seen him over there for...
This is none of your business.
I say like four months straight. You need to handle your business. That's what you need to do.
I handle my business.
Shante.
You obviously don't.
You're the godmother, Gianna. Are you doing what he should be doing? Is that it?
Yes, me and her sister, we take good care of her. She is not about the financial. It's just that people been bashing her around the city, believing his lies and stuff. And the truth don't really need support. She just doing this so everybody can see. You get where I'm coming from? I take good care of Gigi. Her auntie take good care of her. Anything she needs, she get in her other
mama. Yeah, damn well that ain't my baby. Y'all tripping with you.
Okay. So, Carlos, what's the story here? Do you believe your son or do you believe Emily? Is this your granddaughter or not?
Man, I started out in the beginning, Mark. I mean, just by him telling me that it wasn't his baby, that it was someone else's, I started out before anyone ever tried to even step up in the situation. But when I did step up in the situation, she gave my gifts away.
You saw a text message from Emily, and the text message said, Gianna doesn't need you guys. I have someone who will take care of her.
I took that very personally. I'm not going to lie to you because, simple fact, I mean, Facebook is Facebook. You know, should no one get mad over Facebook. Now, it's just Facebook. But,
when it comes down to bashing,
you can't just bash. And, you know, you can bash people, but at the same time, man, you got to understand, people have other family members out there that has to see these things. And I got tired of looking at it.
Apparently, you have some advice for Emily. What's your advice to her?
I mean, I just feel like she needs to grow up. I mean, Facebook is not where you just handle things when it comes down to children. You know, you got to reach out in a respectful way. You know, when it comes down to me.
No, you didn't, Emily.
No, you didn't. Man, you just got to cut that. You got to cut it out.
But
one reason I really stepped back because you was like, okay. Exactly. I have to.
How many times have I had an appointment for a DNA test before I even
okay.
Come
but young girls today, but young girls today, Emily, what you're not understanding is they get pregnant, but they have to go down the line of three dudes. I'm not saying that you doing that, but I heard that you were sleeping with him and another guy at the same time.
Before I read the results here, I've got to find out because I asked this. So, Charlie, if this is your child, you're going to get into her life?
Yeah, I'm going to step up for sure.
Okay. And Carlos, will you be in Gianna's life as well?
Most definitely. Okay. You know, I want to say this as well, you know, with these young women today running around.
It's a two-way street, okay? You can ask women to step up and change their lives. Well, how about the guys stepping up and change their lives too, okay?
Thank you.
All right. Here we go. Here we go.
Hey, if the baby is mine, I'm going to change the life, Maury.
In the case of one-year-old Gianna, Charlie, you are the father.
Can she get an apology? Hey. Okay, listen.
Thank you, baby.
Salute, though. That's salute.
Thank you.
Can I say something? You read the right thing.
It's all right here.
Can I say something more?
Yes.
Gianna is a beautiful girl, you know, and I respect his dad, what he said about stepping up. That's all. It's not even a financial thing. It's not about no going back and forth. I don't know him. It ain't about no money situation. It's just really about Gigi.
I'm finna change the life. Knowing her father.
Okay, fine, everyone. Thank you all very much.
You are not the father.